Very good morning, one and all. Today we would like to discuss about split plot design and its analysis by using software SPSS. Split plot design is a special type of two-factorial experiment. In this, first factor is called as main plot and second factor is called as subplot. In the split plot design, the size of first factor, that is main plot, is usually larger than subplot. Why split plot design is required? For this, two main reasons are there. The reason one is, in a two-factorial experiment, when one factor requires larger experimental unit than another, at that situation, split plot design is required. Particularly for agronomic experiments, some factors, namely irrigation, tillage, drainage, weed management, etc., require larger experimental units, mainly for convenience of management. Coming to reason two, in a two-factorial experiment, when both factors are not equally important, one factor is more important than another, at that situation, split plot design is required. By split plot design, whatever the factor assigned to subplot is estimated precisely than main plot. Let us know layout and randomization of split plot design by using 3 levels of main plot, 5 levels of subplot with 4 replications. In the layout of split plot design, initially we have to divide whole experimental unit into 4 replications as per our example. Replication 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we have to divide each replication into 3 main plots. After the dividing into 3 main plots, we have to assign these main plots in a randomized manner. Now, each and every main plot divided into 5 subplots, and these all 5 subplots V1 to V5 also have to be allocated in a randomized manner. Now, we have to repeat such kind of randomization for second main plot as well as third main plot under replication 1. It is the complete randomization of main plot as well as subplot under replication 1. We have to repeat this randomization for replication 2, replication 3 as well as replication 4. It is the complete layout as well as randomization of split plot design by using 3 main plots, 5 subplots with 4 replications. Let us see ANOVA table of split plot design. In this one, 3 major sources of variations are there, that is main plot, main plot, subplot, as well as interaction of main plot as well as subplot. One more interesting thing is, in the split plot design, 2 errors are there. Error 1, error 2. Error 1 is related to main plot, where error 2 is related with subplot as well as interaction. As in the calculation of F ratio of main plot, the main plot mean sum of square is divided with error 1. Similarly, for subplot as well as interaction, it is divided with error 2. That's why error 2 is related with subplot interaction, where error 1 is related with main plot. Let us analyze split plot design by using SPSS for the following example. For this one, I have taken main plot, that is method of sowing, with 2 levels M1, M2 and subplot, that is fertilizer dosages with three levels S1, S2, S3 with 5 replication for the data of yield, that is kg per hectare. As already we discussed, split plat design, three major sources of variations are estimated, that is main plat, subplat, interaction, that is main into subplat. For the analysis of split plat design, initially we have to arrange our data in a column wise pattern as per our data labels, that is replication, main, sub, yield. Main is main plat, sub is subplat, yield is our yield data. After arranging our data in a column wise arrangement, we have to copy this data in the data view of SPSS. Now let us do directly by using software. After copying our data in SPSS data view, replication, main, sub, yield, after copying in the data view, we have to choose analyze menu, then select general linear model, then choose univariate. Now select our yield as a dependent variable and rest of replication, main as well as sub under fixed factor. Now select option model. To create our ANOVA term, we have to choose model option. Under this one, select build term. Now create our term. First of all, we have to choose replication, then choose main, then choose main into replication. For that one, select control button first, then choose main as well as replication. After pressing control button, we have to choose both main and replication and send to model. Main into replication is nothing but error 1. Main into replication is nothing but error 1. After choosing replication, main, error 1, now subplot, now interaction. For that one also again press control button, main as well as sub. Now select here. Error 2 we need not select. By default SPS will be produced. Now click continue. After choosing replication, main into replication, that is error 1, sub, main into sub. Just click continue. Now choose paste option. Now immediately remove this full stop. Just press enter and give slash write test. Give space, write main versus main into replication. Sorry, all should be small letters. Just to give full stop. It is the required syntax code. It is the required syntax code for split plot design. After writing this one and put full stop here, now click run. Select all. In the output view, our result of split plat design is generated. As we have taken replication, 5 replications, 2 main plats, subplots. If you see the ANOVA table, the important terms are main factor, sub, main into sub. One more important point have to remember is, we shouldn't check for main plot F value as well as significant value. We have to see this one. We shouldn't see F value, significant value of main plot. We haven't checked this one. We have to consider this value. It is the important point have to be remembered. So, the main plot probability value is 0.155. Subplot probability value is 0.019. Interaction probability value is 0.613. So, among all, subplot is significant because its probability value is less than 0.05. So, now we have to calculate CD or Duncan test something for subplot only to know the significant difference. For that one, again, go to data view, select analyze, general linear model, univariate, select post hoc option. Under this one, among all, only subplot is significant. That's why we are sending subplot for post hoc. Now, we are selecting LSD. LSD is nothing but critical difference. You may select Duncan, Dunnett, 2K, whatever you feel important. Generally, it is LSD is sufficient for this test. After selecting LSD, just click continue, press OK. Among our three subplots, one with two, one with three, among all, if you check significant value, only one with three is significant among all, because its probability value is less than 0.05. So, only subplot 1, subplot 3 are significant to each other, where subplot 1 and 2, 2 and 3 are on par to each other. By this way, we have to test the significance of subplot. It is the procedure for analysis of split plot design as well as significance of subplot. By this one, we have to analyze split plot design. Still any queries, you can mail me to this address. Thank you. Thank you all.